Sometimes it seems the answer to some of life's problems are right in front of us. What if I told you combining the flu vaccine with a surprising medication already out there on the market, well, together they could treat cancer? Check this out.
For decades, scientists have tested many different medications in hopes of curing one of mankind's deadliest enemies, cancer. Well, recently, one very surprising combination may have paved the way for treatment, mixing an inactivated flu vaccine with erectile dysfunction drugs. Canadian researchers tested this mixture on mice with lung cancer and couldn't believe their findings. They found that after cancer surgery, the body's immune system is left suppressed, and that sexual dysfunction medications may actually help strengthen the immune system and help fight off lingering cancerous cells. But that's not all their findings revealed. When combining those drugs with the flu vaccine, there was a 90% reduction in the spread of the disease. These scientists were so blown away by the results, they're now putting a human clinical trial together to explore their findings even further.
Exactly, the wow response. And to talk through this, we have oncologist Dr. Lawrence Piro join us. And just to remind everyone, this study was on mice. The wows are throughout the crowd. I'm sure people at home are feeling the same way. Is this as groundbreaking as it sounds?
Well, Travis, I think this is a super interesting study on lots of levels. The first is that if you ask just ordinary people that you see as patients about surgery, there has been a long-standing wives tale, doctors have thought wives tale, that if you take the tumor out, it's going to make it spread. I'm sure you've heard that from patients, right? Mm-hmm. And so one interesting thing is that there is now immunology that says that's probably true, and yet doctors have been saying that's a wives tale. This particular study is playing upon that. So the immune system is this incredibly delicate balance. You need to kill the things that are foreign to your body, but not kill the body itself, right? We don't want them to attack our heart or our liver or any of that. So there are cells that are in constant balance. We have natural killer cells that are meant to kill virus-infected cells and to kill cancer cells. And then we have these other cells called MDSC cells. These are suppressor cells. And these cells pull back those killer cells when they're getting too aggressive. It turns out that cancer surgery, or surgery in general, seems to stimulate the suppressor cells that causes them to pull back the killer cells. And now the killer cells aren't killing the cancer and allowing metastasis.
So probably just as a result of the trauma of the surgery, because I mean, if you cut out a tumor and you've gotten the whole thing out, you know that you didn't violate the tumor, you should feel pretty good about it. But this makes sense.